we're at the Walmart. We already went in once. Unfortunately, we weren't filming, or else we wouldn't be going in again, because they certainly don't want us to. We went and asked for a manager. She came over. Once they realized even a hint of what we were doing, she wasn't happy. We said we're making a documentary on Gail Lewis, and she said, not in here. People who do that get kicked out, and that's essentially what we were, was kicked out. Even though we were trying to be very professional, we just wanted to ask a few questions. You know, we're gonna give it another shot. For Gail.
Damn, this card is janky.
Gail wouldn't have allowed that.
No.
Gail would have taken that bad boy out of commission.
Maybe the issue is the manager we dealt with wasn't the one that's been speaking to the media. So. Hey fellas, quick question. You know Gail Lewis is? Yeah?
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah.
What do you make of this whole Gail Lewis sensation?
It's funny. Like,
yeah, I thought it was funny at first, but now
I'm
scared.
I'm very surprised at how quick it blew up.
Yeah, like out of nowhere, it just blows up. Because, I mean, I saw like a reel for it, and then like a few weeks later, then it blew up. Then everyone was talking about it. Yeah.
See the animations on Instagram and everything.
I don't know.
Yeah, he doesn't know what's going on.
Wasn't there a signing here recently, or like a meet and
greet? No, that was meet and greet somewhere else, yeah.
Yeah, it was in Aurora. That's funny.
You know what they say, all roads lead to Gail. Excuse me? Do you work here?
No.
They glow in the dark.
I'm a film student. I'm doing a documentary project on the Gail Lewis situation and the impact okay. Would you
want to say anything? This is private property. Can't film on property
either. Oh, really?
Yes. So it's hard not to.
I think he's
mad.
Yeah.
All right.
All right.
Signing up.
So we've done some digging and we've actually found out the reason none of these people are open to talking to us is because this place has been quite the media circus. There's been nonstop phone calls to the store phone, and jackasses like us are trying to make vlogs to get clicks on YouTube. And all the employees are just kind of tired of it. So you can't get much information out of them, to be honest. Excuse me? You know where Gail Lewis is at? Gail Lewis?
No.
Oh, okay. Here we are in the 844 itself. We spent a good amount of time talking to customers, talking to associates, managers, trying to find where Gail Lewis is, and frankly, they're giving us the cold shoulder. I guess that means that we're gonna have to do the work ourselves and go find Gail, so let's go.
Hey.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Gail's son?
Yeah. Yep, I'm Doug.
I'm Jaden.
Hi.
Shoes off? Shoes off?
Oh, no, you're fine. You can leave your shoes on. Hey, how you doing?
Good. Nice to meet
you. Nice to meet you, too. I'm Gail Lewis. Hey, how you doing?
Hi, Gail. Nice to meet you.
There you are. Cool, thanks for having us.
No problem, I hope it was all right trip for you.
It was.
Doug, my son Douglas.
Douglas.
Hi.
Cool, thank you for having us in your home.
Sure, no problem, anytime.
How have you guys been?
Oh, not too bad.
I'm all right.
He's been all right. Just been kind of a little overwhelmed a little bit, but I mean, like, I think I'm getting the hang of it now.
Sure.
Now, this is the only thing I was able to save from Walmart right here when I quit. This is the original vest from the video.
Was Gail already written on it?
Yeah, Gail was already written on it because it was my vest. I didn't want anybody else wearing it. But it's still mine.
You had that single one for a long time?
For about 3-4 years now. It's kind of tied up right there, but yeah, about 3 or 4 years now. And I don't think I'll ever let it go. It's iconic now.
I was going to ask, you're not going to auction it off, right?
No, no. Maybe if I'm desperate, but no, I'm just kidding. But yeah, I mean, like...
It's sacred.
It is. My garb. But yeah, I mean, like, I didn't want anybody else wearing it at work because it got really hot in that store, and you don't want somebody else's BO on it. It was... I rather have my own.
What section were you working in?
I was actually maintenance, overnight maintenance at Walmart. And I first started off as a stocker, but then when I had my knee surgery, I ended up having to take it a little bit more easier, and maintenance was easier. But then once my knee got better, I just kind of stuck with it because it was fun. Please have a seat.
All right. So
what's going on?
So as I told you before we met, I'm from like the next town over. And during this whole sensation of you, the fact that you're from the next town over here in Morris, you know, I hit close to home because I've always known Morris, and here you are, someone famous now coming out of Morris. And it put all the viral people and the history of the internet and all of the memes into perspective. Made me realize, you know, everything's real, everything's rooted in reality, and this just happened to be like a reality really close to home. And I thought, you know, maybe this could be my opportunity to bring your experience to light and let you kind of give your testimonial on how everything's been. And I want to show that there is a real person behind the Gail Lewis meme, the actual Gail Lewis. I was hoping we could find out more about you today.
All right, yeah, sure, not a problem. Sounds awesome.
Let's do it.
All right.
So as I said before, I'm just really interested in your whole experience, very unique experience. So I kind of got some comprehensive questions. First, I want to ask you about your Walmart years, you know, the 10 years leading up to you leaving Walmart and you posting that video, and then your background even before Walmart. So however much you're willing or wanting to share about your life. So yeah, my first question is, what is your background? What's your life story?
My life story is I was born in 1981. Lived in Fox Lake until like 97, and then we moved out into Shanahan, Illinois. And then after that, we moved to Morris here in 2000. And my first job ever was McDonald's, and I've been working ever since the day I turned 16. And back then in the like early 90s, late 90s, laws were less lenient, so I was able to actually work overnights like I do now. And I really haven't seen the sun in like so long. And after that, I mean, like, I kind of flip-flopped around. I went from like job to job to job. I didn't find a job that actually suited me. It was mostly like fast food, or there was a store out in Minooka called Super Value. They went out of business when Jewel came in. And then finally, I actually found Walmart. It took me a while to get in there. And once I got in there, I started working at Walmart. And it's been like 10 years, and like it was actually a really good experience working there. I enjoyed every moment of it, up to the very end.
So, who is Gail Lewis? Who is the enigmatic Gail Lewis? What makes you you?
Who is Gail Lewis? I always try to be a good person. If I have the means to help you out, I can try to help you out. My vest that sold for $13,420, I did not want a penny of that. I actually donated it because I felt it was the right thing to do. Always try to do the right thing is the best way I can explain it. It's like, because I've always been kind of been used my whole life, and I don't want to see anybody else have that happen to them too. So how else can I... do good is by doing good.
You do seem like a wonderful person.
Thank you.
Do you want to tell me about some of your interests? Like, I wasn't expecting to get into it so much, but you have your Hearse things, and you love movies and stuff, which obviously I do.
Right. My interests are Well, of course my hearse. I mean, I love my hearse. That's my baby right there. All right, so I bought this here in town for like $3,000. I literally have put in about $10,000 of repair into it. 1985 Cadillac Fleetwood front end. The other, they cut the hearse in, the car in half, and they pull it apart so that way it makes it long. It's all hand built by this end. The toys and stuff there are actually for the little girl. She still hangs out. I can actually feel her spirit sometimes. That's my daily driver too.
No.
Yeah.
That means, of course, now too. But all those times that you were working at Walmart, in parking lot, you were parking this.
Yes, for the last 2 years of working at Walmart. In the meantime, I was actually on foot. It's a 3 mile walk from here to Walmart, and it'd take about 45 minutes.
As well as bike as well.
Oh yeah, biking too. And I would do that every single day. And because like, this is my inspiration here, that my guy. I'm hoping to get this fixed up. I mean, like, it took me forever. Whoever had this before me did not take good care of it. I'm trying to restore it. His name is Rocky the Rockstar.
Actually means away from town.
Somebody left a little note on my car saying I want to buy it. It rocks. I'm like, okay, so that's how he got his name, was Rocky the Rockstar. Everybody thinks Rocky Horror? No, Rocky Rockstar. I also like collecting video games. I actually got into collecting cards when we used to have the card days over at Walmart. And I learned how to like find the right cards and everything, like baseball cards, Pokemon cards. I love movies, obviously. I go to the thrift store here in town and I collect clam cases on Disney films and stuff like that. And I also like to go a little bit weird shopping through there. If something catches my eye, like my hat back there, the one with the feather on it, that I found at a thrift store during Halloween time, and it's actually real.
I was surprised to see that you'd actually been making TikToks long before this majorly viral one. Why'd you start making TikTok in the first place?
What started me on TikTok was my son. He actually got into it before I did when it first came out. And at first I was like, you know, you would believe the hype of everybody saying the same thing. Oh, they're stealing your data. So I was like, I wasn't going to do it. But then I'm like, you know what? This actually looks like fun. And people were actually interacting with it. And it was actually a lot better than YouTube and Facebook because, like, you would find your own people on it. Like, okay, I'm a video game collector. Next thing you know, I'm hanging out with video game people on TikTok, but if I were to do that on Facebook or YouTube, I would get like being called a noob and I would just get booted off right away. So I actually found my people on TikTok.
What's one of your favorite videos you made?
One of my favorite videos I made? Okay, I got so many of them. I think it would be the one with my son actually doing the can-can in front of the Walgreens.
So just about the video and your emotional sign-off in the video of leaving Walmart, what prompted you to make that video that now has over 30 million views? Like, what made you want to make that video and share it?
What made me make that video was for, like, probably about 3-4 years, we would always mess around with the walkies at work. We would like hit them like going click, click, click when somebody's walking by. And then like if the manager was doing something over the PA system, you can actually hear it. Or we would like put the walkies together and make that loud squelching noise. And that would always tick off the management. And my supervisor, the day that he knew I was leaving, he's like, you got to do one last special something. He's like, yeah, figure it out. And I told him like, you better record it for me. And he did, and that's what you see with me, the Morris, Illinois 844 signing out. And I got home, and I'm in my hearse, and I'm watching the video. I'm already emotional from the day because I already knew I was going to miss everybody. And I'm like, right now is the best time to record that second half of that video. And it just that's how it ended up being what it is today. Today was an end of an era for me. It's a happy sad because I'm going to be going to a better job. And those people became like family.
Some of your word choice lingers in my head. You talk about it being the end of an era, and you talk about a happy, sad feeling. What does the end of an era mean to you, and can you elaborate more on that happy, sad feeling?
End of the era means that actually came from my son. He told me, he's like, Mom, it's about time to end the era, like go into something else besides fast food or retail. And where I'm at now, where he's like, it's an end of the era. So my son actually coined that phrase for me. And then the happy sad is actually, I'm happy that I'm leaving Walmart, but I'm sad to see everybody go at the exact same time, because we were like a tight-knit family. I would actually see people at Walmart more than I would see my own family.
We're all deeply familiar with the minute or so of your final day at Walmart that was recorded on video. But what about the rest of the day that wasn't caught on video? Could you walk me through that day? That'll surely go down in internet history.
The final day before the video was played, or recorded, excuse me, I was actually really sad. I mean, the week before, I was crying my eyes out because I already knew where this was going to go. I mean, like, I'm going to miss these guys, but then, like, I knew I'm going to be going to a better job. And my supervisor, I mean, like, the one that took the video, he was a really good guy. I mean, like, everybody else really became family. And so the whole entire day, I was just bawling my eyes out, but trying to keep my composure together and keep on working and pushing through, like taking out the garbage and going outside to the parking lot and picking up the trash out there. And in the meantime, I'm trying to do that and just try to keep myself together. And it was really hard for me to do that. I want to say 60% of that day, I had to stop for about 5 minutes and go into the bathroom and dry my eyes because I was crying so much. And I mean, I really do miss those guys. I mean, I'm starting to tear up right now.
How long did it take for the video to pick up traction?
I want to say it started within the first hour, because like within the first hour, it started going from like 100, which that was what I was normally used to, was like seeing 100 views, to all of a sudden it went to 1,000. I'm like, okay, that's all right. And then the following like hour, it went up even higher, went to 22,000, and then it went up to 400,000. I'm like, okay, this is getting weird. And then I'm noticing there was a lot of people reposting it, and the reposts were getting more people drawn in. It just kept going crazier and crazier after that. And then the following day, I wake up and I was at like 13.5 mil on just on the day one. And I'm like, okay. And then as it's the week went on, it slowed down a bit, but it just still kept on going higher and higher. When it first started going like it was, like, first I got scared because, like, I didn't want it to interfere with my new job. I mean, like, I am a hard worker and I am really dedicated to what I got to do, and I'll make sure it gets done no matter what. But I was more concerned about, like, safety for where I was going to, and, like, everybody else at Walmart, like what's going to happen to them, because we've seen things go crazy before over viral videos that are supposed to be meaning to be sweet and happy.
Did you ever consider taking the video down?
I almost considered taking the video down, but then like by that time it's been reposted so many times, and by that time I can't take it down. It was starting to gain a lot of traction around that time, but again, like every time I kept seeing a repost, I'm like, oh man, I'm a little scared because like I said, I didn't want it to interfere with my new job.
How does it feel to be an overnight celebrity? Because of course the video blew up, but like people are latching on to you as well. They're making up lore and they know your name, your very name. I mean, you're not just known as Walmart lady because you say Gail Lewis right in the video. So it's completely you. How does that feel?
Because it seems to happen somewhat frequently today, you know, in the internet era.
Right. What it feels like to be an overnight celebrity, it almost feels like a dream. Like, did it really just happen? I mean, like, is this happening right now? How is this even going like it is right now? And then you try to take a nap and see if you are dreaming. And then you have to look at it again, and then, like, just how people are reacting to it is actually what, and it still feels like a dream right now, honestly. I'm starting to feel like I'm waking up, but I mean, like, what would you do if it was you that had that happen? You're like, okay, is this real? I mean, this don't feel real to me.
Why do you think you went viral?
I think I went viral because, like, you see these other people quitting Walmart, they are more like F Walmart this, and or they're like, there's a, they go into a whole speech over why they did, they quit Walmart, and it was always a negative reaction. I think it was mainly actually the sign off, because like everybody was saying that I signed off like an officer, and then like they realized it was actually meant to be very sweet, and I think that's what actually touched with people too.
Your sincerity then, yeah.
Yeah. The sign off was not supposed to be as a joke. It was actually like my last thing for the store.
Right.
And that was actually sincerity too. And I mean, that was 100% real crying in the car. But yeah, you see these other videos that are out, and these people are like trashing Walmart as they're leaving. But I think I was actually one of the nicer ones that was out there.
Manage it and this job. I quit.
Has Walmart reached out to you?
In the beginning, they have not. But they reached out to me one time, and they wanted to take my video and use it, give them credit for my video. And I thought that was strange. They even changed their TikTok page with my badge on it for like a full week, thinking that they were going to get the video, but I have not responded to them yet.
I wonder if they'll put you in like a Super Bowl ad.
I think that I get money on that one.
Oh my
that's going to a good charity.
What did everyone think? Friends, family, and coworkers? What did everyone think? What were they saying?
All of a sudden, like, I'm getting phone calls from people that I haven't talked to in years or in months. And they're like, do you know that you're getting viral? I'm like, yeah, that's what the last person said before you said. And then I found out that the Walmart here in town was actually a huge media circus. There's too many people walking around, looking around for me when I'm not even there. They actually loved the video, but they were actually upset about the fact that what was the aftermath of it, because people were acting so stupid when it came to that. They're getting prank phone calls, which they're still getting prank phone calls to this day. They have people walking around with blog sets and like going up to other associates, stopping them from doing their job to find out where I'm at. It's been really crazy for them over there, but they love the video. They just hate the aftermath.
What does Douglas think?
Hi, I'm Douglas.
How have you handled this whole thing?
It's been okay. Like, the good bit is, like, you know, helping out everybody else, and, like, you know, sometimes we get, like, you know, free stuff, and, like, you know, she's making money off, like, the cameo stuff. But most of the other downsides is, like, for some reason, like, when someone leaked, like, where her current job is or whatever, we had to, like, you know, hide or something stupid like that. Like, we had to actually, like, you know, spy kind of stuff, and we had to keep doing that for like a couple of days because, like, you know, idiots were trying to like take a picture of Gail or, like, you know, causing riots and that sort of shit.
I'll be back in, gentlemen.
Alright.
Imagine waking up to school every morning, listen to this. 6 o'clock in the morning. Late 80s to the early 2000s, I can tell you almost every single country music song that's out there. My family tortured me with country music. The one thing she would always wake us up in the morning was Herb Albert and Tijuana Brass with Cream Delights. I don't know if you ever heard that one, but that is annoying to wake up to. And that was every day waking up for school. I'm not gonna find that for you. And it would just like rattle the whole house completely, and oh my god, I hated it so much, especially listening to this one. Like waking up 6 o'clock in the morning, go to school, and you're listening to Herb Albert and Tijuana on the Brass.
So you want to be a video game designer?
Yeah.
That's cool.
Like, I've been primarily just doing art and that sort of stuff.
That is for my bird friend that attacked me in that one video.
There's a bird. Hey, birdie.
His name is Sammy. He actually lives in that little cubby hole right there next to the rag. And he comes by every night. And I put out some seed for him. And he loves it. And I keep him happy. He keeps me happy. He's my good luck charm.
How do you feel about the viral fame? Like, on behalf of your mom and, like, to yourself, is it overwhelming? Is it scary? Is it exciting?
It's been okay. Like, there has been, like, one time, like, I never told you this, and I still don't want to fully tell you that. Like, when I was walking from, like, work to home or whatever, like, I actually was, like, you know, insanely talking to myself, but it's the best way I can talk about it, or say it, like, you know, upset kind. Like, it's more than just, like, you know, that thing. It's, like, a bunch of stuff happened in my life at that same time.
You're saying it was just kind of stressful, too?
Yeah, something like that.
Mm-hmm.
Douglas, I think he thinks it's cool. In the beginning, he thought it was hilarious because we would read the comments. One of my favorite ones was, is like, I served with Gail at the Old Navy. Like, going on, like, a three-year spree or a tour or whatever they call it. And me and him would just, like, crack up over these comments. But now he's starting to, like, hate it, I think.
You know, I'm wondering, how did Walmart handle the media circus? Because their number, it's posted right online, so I understand why they got a lot of calls. Did they just stop answering the phone?
No, they cannot not stop answering the phone because they got deliveries and other things coming in at all hours of the day there. So they had to keep answering the phone, but I really honestly don't know too much about that because I tried to stay away from that until it started to calm down. But I did talk to a lady yesterday, and she was telling me that it calmed down, but there's still phone calls coming in, and they're like really disturbing phone calls. And it's like that they still have to keep answering the phone because they got meat and produce trucks and other deliveries, and the only way you can get a hold of them is through the Walmart telephone number.
Are they disturbing because they're being like, they're prying for information and things?
Some of it prying for information. Others is like, I have 37 husbands and they all want to know if I'm okay. I'm not kidding. I have 37 husbands, apparently.
That is something.
I want to know where those guys are at. They owe me.
Well, I'm sorry that's happening. That sounds creepy.
I know. I mean, like, that stuff right there, I mean, like, that's what makes it creepy. And, like, other people are just wanting to, like, get, like, an autograph or have me do a video for them. That's mostly what they're calling for.
With all the ways the internet's spinned off your video, you know, with different jokes like, you know, serving boards in the produce section or whatever, reflecting on other reactions and comments from your viral video, has there been a specific message or connection from viewers that stood out to you and left a lasting impression?
One of the things that actually did stand out from, like, all of the memes and everything that was out there was actually the very first meme that I saw. And the girl, I reached out to her. I'm like, however you did that, that was hilarious. And she's like, oh my God, I'm so sorry, I thought you'd be offended. I'm like, no, keep it up, because that was actually really funny. And I told her, just keep it up, and she almost pulled it down. If she didn't pull that down, it would never been what it is today, too.
What was that?
It was the one where I'm standing, doing my normal sign off, and then it goes into a background of America's Hero, but with a flag behind me playing Taps, and she ends up cracking up laughing at the end.
And she thought you might be offended.
Yeah, she thought I'd be offended because there was actually two other videos before that, and these guys were just making fun of me. But, I mean, like, I can't be disturbed by that, you know.
Do you feel at all mocked or made fun of?
I feel mocked and made fun of. I mean, like, who doesn't make fun of anybody online nowadays? I mean, like, but I can actually handle it. I mean, like, I got thick skin. I mean, like, it gets personal when people start coming to my house or going to my new job because they found out where I work at and everything. That's when it starts getting personal.
Mm-hmm. So it's required some thick skin, in a way, right?
Yeah, oh yeah, definitely.
On the contrary, you've also gotten a lot of love, I guess, and attention. So what's that been like?
Just like the last one, it almost feels like a dream because, like, my whole entire life, I've been pretty much crapped on. And I never knew that I can get this much love from people just from, like, making a video. I don't know. It's almost like a dream like this, too, because, like, I don't know how to handle something like this. And, I mean, I love all my fans anyway. I mean, like, I do appreciate them. I mean, I wouldn't be here today, and you wouldn't be here today hanging out with me. Recently, I just got into Cameo, and I'm doing, like, personal videos, like, happy birthday, Merry Christmas, or just roasting people.
Has your Cameo been pretty popular?
Yes, my Cameo has been doing really good right now. I just did 331 of them right now it's the 27th, so I started doing that about a week ago. I have 35 more to go, and I think I actually may have gotten another one probably in the last, like, 5 minutes.
Do you think it's going to keep going for a while?
If it does, I mean, it'd be awesome. But if it ends, I mean, like, at least I had a good ride with it.
So you've gotten a lot of love online, but there's also been a share of hate, because that's the nature of the internet. What would you say to some of the people who are more so mocking you, or the haters, as you could call them, or I guess the people who are straight up disturbing you, because as you said, some people have shown up here. What's your message to them?
My message to them, the ones that show up to my house, stop it. Because everybody has their own personal space, and, like, my house is my home, and, like, I have a neighbor downstairs, and he is not thrilled about it.
Have you confronted them?
I have confronted a few of them. Not too long ago, I had these kids that blocked me in over at the alleyway where I normally leave. And my hearse is a huge vehicle in a small alley like it is. And they blocked me in, and I had to yell at them, like, guys, you got to move. I got to go to work. You're disturbing my neighbors. Please leave. And they wouldn't leave until they got a picture with me.
Did you give them that picture?
I gave them the picture, but I was not happy in those pictures.
It's like, why do we need so many cops? It's a video.
So were the cops here?
No, she was saying, like, a cop was, like, protecting me or something like that, but, like, why do I need a cop to protect me? It shouldn't be that serious.
No, the reason why I had a couple extra police officers to watch him, because, like, there was some people that were actually trying to break in. Oh, excuse me.
Yeah.
Oh, you can say it there, bud. I had people, like, literally trying to break in one night. I heard somebody knocking on my door, especially with all the random people just showing up out of nowhere. it was just too much, and I wanted to make sure that he was safe because I knew he was walking to work.
How'd the meet and greet go?
No, the meet and greet went awesome. I mean, we had at least 200 people. We raised $1,726 for the Children's Miracle Network. And people were very respectful. The second I walked in, they all started cheering and pulling out their phones, and I'm like, here I am, people, hi.
I had more fun with, like, the arcade stuff.
Yeah, you did talk to Eric Shun and had fun with him.
Yeah, I was talking to him. He was doing, like, a PS5 giveaway thing or whatever that was signed by, you know, my mom here. He also allowed me to, like, you know, sign on it as well.
What were people saying to you at the meet and greet? Was there a theme with what everyone was saying to you?
A lot of them were like, if you ever saw a chihuahua shaking really bad, some of the kids were like really stiff, and they're like, oh my god, hi. I'm like, are you okay? I mean, calm down, it's okay, it's just me, I'm Gail, how you doing? Calm down, it's alright, hon. I would have to calm a lot of them down. A lot of them were telling me that I'm an icon. I don't feel like an icon, honestly. A lot of them were like, we love you, Gail. Thank you so much for your service. I had people saluting me.
So a couple months ago, you would not have thought that you were going to be doing meet and greets and autographs.
No, not a few months ago.
I mean, yeah, if you were told you were going to become famous, what would you even think it'd be about?
If I thought I was going to be famous for something, it would honestly, because, like, I used to ride my bike to work every day, because I didn't have a car for over, like, 10 years. That was my original baby. That was my horse right there. I always called him that. I called him Coke Cheese from, like, a Bonanza. You ever watch that show? And I would, like, put, like, bike lights all over it, and I would, like, jam out music, and I would actually have, like, a strobe light going on my bike, and it was actually catch people's attention. I think I'd be more famous for that, not the viral video that I got right now today. Like, the little light right there on the top had the horse sign on it, so, like, I would hit the horse button and go, yeah!
So the hearse was your first car in 10 years?
Yes, that was my first car in 10 years. Before that, I had a Lincoln Mark 7 1985, and my mom sold it out from underneath me because her name was on the title. And then during that whole time, for the 10 years that I did work at Walmart, I was making a 3-mile walk in both directions there and back. Sometimes I would get rides from people. Sometimes I didn't. I would ride my bike all the time. And I have no ACL or cartilage in my left knee. So, I mean, it was actually helping me out with walking and riding sometimes, too, if I needed to.
How has this whole experience changed your perspective on social media and its influence on people? Just, like, yeah, what do you think of social media now? We all know it's weird, but now you're like, part of the... You've firsthand experienced the weirdness and the spontaneity of it and all of that.
I think the... I think anybody can pretty much be a sensation if you hit the right thing. I always thought the most personal is the one that hits the hardest with people, and it obviously did. And I mean, like, it can get weird sometimes, but then it can also be really empowering too on top of it.
And this is a very existential question, something maybe I'd only think of, but did you have any like premonition about fame coming your way? Was there any fate involved, do you think? Anything there?
When I did the sign-off video at Walmart, I did feel like something was there. I honestly did feel like something was there. And when I did the crying in the hearse, I knew something was actually coming together at that moment, but I didn't realize it was going to come in this strong. And I did actually have a feeling on it, just a small one, but I mean, it still was there.
That's a sign so that I'm hitting something good, apparently.
What was your motivation for posting the video?
To show that my coworkers, that I actually care about them and that I am going to miss them, and I actually did enjoy working with them. And the sign off, like I said, it wasn't a joke. It was like my last thing I could do for them.
Is there anyone over there at your old Walmart who kind of resents this all, resents the whole situation?
Some do resent it. I know that, but it's not my fault. I mean, what happened over there. I do talk to a lot of my old coworkers. I was actually there the day before today, or day after Christmas, I'm sorry. And I went in there, I had to get some shoes, and I ran into a few old coworkers, and they're like, you know what, we don't hate you, we love you. You know what, that was one of the sweetest videos we've seen in a long time, and they said they did miss me. It was just crazy because of what the aftermath was like.
How do you balance, like, your dual life? Because in your day, you have, like, this exciting fame and then you still gotta put your nose to the grindstone and go to work. So, you know, there's the reality and there's the fame. How do you balance all that?
It's actually really difficult, believe it or not. Like, one minute I could be like, okay, I'm normal Gail working at my new job, and if I step outside and somebody recognizes me, I have to put on a show for them, like a show pony. Like, hey, can I take a picture with you? Okay. And it's mostly that, and the balance I have found is just take some time for myself and try to find a way to just make it through. That's the best I got. And then with the work, I mean, I'm still working hard. I'm doing the job that I'm supposed to be doing, because I, like I said, I am not the type of person to stand back and be lazy when it comes to something like this. I will try to do my best. Sometimes when I'm outside, I gotta admit it, I want a little bit of the attention, but there's other times, like when I'm at home, I've been like more recluse than anything else. I don't want to really get out there and like kind of react with people. I mean, like, I've always been like on a bike introvert, but I mean, like, this is like it, the feeling of scariness on top of it was making it a little bit more hard to go out. And I would mostly, if I needed something from the store, I would send my son out to the store, or he would come with me as my bodyguard. Or we went to a restaurant here in town and ordered a pizza, I would try to sit down and eat a pizza, and somebody would be coming up wanting to take a picture of me as I'm eating. It's like, I will have to be like, guys, I'm sorry, I'm in the middle of a dinner right now. I will take a picture with you later if you're still here. And they, most of them have been very respectful about it.
Has it dawned on you that this could in some ways be like the peak excitement that you'll see in a certain way, not to take away from any of the other accomplishments in life, but this is just such a once in a lifetime occurrence. Is it hard to calm down from that?
It definitely is hard to come down, but I was always told when I was a kid, if you ever get famous, the shooting star shall rise, but it will always come down, and sometimes it crashes down, and I don't want to be the one that crashes.
In your video, you said you were going to a new job and that it was hopefully going to be a better job. Has it been? How's your new job been?
My new job is actually really good. I mean, it's a better opportunity. It is better pay, and it's been a most... very more friendly atmosphere, and I know I'm doing good in this one, and I know I can make a difference in the world doing this job.
Have you guys been each other's biggest support and like confidant in all of this, you think?
Oh, he has been, definitely 100%, and I want to thank you, bud.
All right.
Come here.
Yeah.
Hey. You've been a good kid.
Yeah.
How do you think all your experience at Walmart, when you actually work there and the relationships you build in the community you belong to, how do you think that, as well as everything that came after with the viral fame, how do you think all of this, this and that chapter of your life will influence your future endeavors and relationships and anything?
I feel like it could also open up plenty of opportunities. Maybe if I ever decide that I want to leave the job that I'm at right now, which probably ain't gonna happen, I probably might get a job anywhere that I want now, I hope. But I also, like I said, I want people to, like, you know, if people could be better to each other and be kind, I mean, that's all we need in this world more now than ever, because there's so much hate going on. A couple weeks ago, I get a letter in the mail from Mrs. Sue Resin, a senator. It's very rare to get a letter from a senator.
Could you read what the senator said?
Update this angle. Congratulations on your retirement from Walmart. I have seen you all over the social media and news. I'm sorry, what does that say?
I am confident you will be greatly missed. I hope your retirement brings you the contentment and relaxation you have earned. My best wishes go with you as you journey into retirement. May you retire knowing that you have made a remarkable contribution and touched the lives of your customers and colleagues in the best ways. I wonder if she thinks you're fully retired.
I know,
that's
right?
I
think, and that's what she's thinking as well, too, but I think that's hilarious.
The Knights of Columbus hat?
Knights of Columbus hat.
Wow. I have a big head, so it probably won't fit. Yep. Sure enough. Should we take a cruise in the hearse?
Yeah. We'll take it to the park.
You want to?
Yeah. Oh, there you are. Got my keys.
Nice.
So carpool karaoke with Gail Lewis. What's your favorite song?
Favorite song? It's a rap song. California Lovin'. California Dreamin', I think it is, by Tupac.
Wow, I was not expecting rap.
Oh, I'm a rap girl.
That's
not the right one.
California Love?
I think it's California Dreamin'. California love. It's my jam right here. City of Compton. Keep it rockin'. Now let me welcome everybody to the wild, wild west. The state is a testimony like Alieness. It's like kicking ears off like a sun to your chest. With the best looking Jimmy in the city of sex.
Hey, I have an idea.
Yeah, what's up?
Should we go check out the sacred temple?
Oh god, I don't know. You want to?
Whenever I try to compare your fame to other famous figures online, I try to pick people to compare it to, because just a select few people haven't heard of you. Who would you compare yourself to?
Maybe that old lady that goes la, 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 la. That one.
There is one more big meme with Walmart. Do you remember the yodeling kid?
Oh, yeah, that yodeling kid?
Yeah.
I only watched maybe like one of those memes, honestly, to tell you the truth on that one.
Oh, he's pretty big.
Yeah, he was like, yodeling. Yeah, they're trying to like compare me to that kid and he's part of my army or something.
Someone needs to write a song. You know how Old Town Road, you know Old Town Road?
Yeah.
You know, it's got country and like hip hop. They should write a song. He can do like the country parts, Mason Ramsey, and you could do like a rap verse.
Oh, that'd be cool.
Make it happen.
Make it happen. Such a beautiful dream. I love rap music. I mean, my mom would never let me listen to that when I was a kid. She always called it gangster music. It's like just because she heard it on Oprah one time, that was it. My mom was always like, if something was like a kid with special needs was on Oprah, I was always that kid that because she wanted that to happen.
What do you mean by that?
Like, okay, a kid with a mental illness or something like that, my mom would always like compare me to that kid that was on that show.
Oh.
And it was always me. It was never my siblings or anything like that. What are you doing? You got your blinker going. But yeah, imagine walking this every single day from my house to here. Or riding a bike and dealing with the rain. The snow is the worst. Because the city doesn't shovel off the sidewalks here. And then people with businesses just shovel the snow right onto the sidewalks.
Oh, man.
And trying to climb over that was like a challenge every year.
Did you ever have to turn around? Because you're like, I can't walk through this
thing? No, I always pushed on through. But then I still put in a good day's worth of work, too. And then walk all the way home again. Coming in hot. Oh, it is busy today.
How long do you think it'll take till someone recognizes you?
Probably like within the first like couple minutes. If there's a lot of people in there that's seen the video, which I'm pretty sure they have. But if it gets like any crazy, I gotta dip out.
They don't have a reserve spot for you?
No, they should.
They should.
Exact spot where I did the sign out video. Right where we're at right now. This is Gail Lewis, 10-year associate, Morris, Illinois, 844, signing out. Good night.
You think there's any of your past coworkers that would want to talk to us real quick?
I don't know if, because this is, like I said, this is a whole different shift, but we can, but I don't think they're allowed to talk about it either. Because they were getting in trouble for, one kid actually blurted it out where I was at, and he got in big trouble for that too.
Supposedly, she works at the
Hey, what's up? What's going on?
Wow.
Wow?
Wow.
Yeah, I know, right?
I don't know what
to do. Come on now. Does it at least slow down with these people asking about me? Oh, don't worry about that.
You don't know the chaos it caused.
Is it really bad?
Every single day, like 100 phone calls.
And has it slowed down at least?
Well, when they started giving the non-emergency phone number to everybody.
I heard about that. They were giving the people were asking for my phone number, so the people were actually giving them the non-emergency to the Morris Police Department.
Talk to the ladies in the fitting room if you want more, because truthfully, the ladies in the fitting room were screening all the phone calls. Those poor girls.
They were really mad at me, huh?
No, they were just screening all the phone calls. It's like somebody had to sit there all day long and answer every phone call.
I heard about it. It was like a big.
And it's like there was legitimately customers trying to call the store that couldn't get through because.
Yeah, because, I mean, like, you're not mad at me, you're just mad at the situation, right?
Yeah. It wasn't you. Nobody was targeting you. It was just one of those, really, again, another one. Can we please get our job done today?
Right.
Yeah. It was frustrating, but...
At least it slowed down, so that's a good sign. Okay, Kenny's coming.
Oh, yeah, sure, please. If that's okay.
Okay.
I just want to ask, I don't want to bombard you.
Turn around, don't drown.
Oh, I've driven through this puddle 100 times, but it's Lake Titicaca.
Lake Titicaca.
Yeah.
Lake Titicaca.
Yeah, because it stinks. You don't want to get caught in that. Are you yelling at me? We gotta go!
You want a picture with her?
Yes,
yes.
You have to ask. Crazy. Even after all this time, you really can't escape it, huh?
No.
That's it's a little just intimidating, I'm sure.
Oh, it is. Getting any readings?
No readings. Oh, I got a 3 there.
Day 1, I took a picture of it, and I didn't realize it until like 3 weeks after. I'm going through my photos, and I actually spotted the what I call Harvey. He mustache, long handlebar mustache, and you can actually like see the bow tie on him that he's wearing, almost like a suit. And then I took the picture on this side, and he was like literally right here in the passenger window. And in the back was the little girl and grandma holding hands, and the little girl's like doing that. It may be weird and unique, but that's me for you. I got another guy coming out in a few days to take a look at it, do a couple of readings on it to actually see and prove if it is real or not. But I already know it is. I mean, I got video of a little girl saying Teddy. I got pictures of a gentleman, like I said, wearing a bow tie and everything. And I know it's haunted for sure, but they're cool.
And right there he is. See him looking at you. He's wearing a bow tie.
What's the thing you like about more? Do you have a favorite like restaurant or?
You ever been to Corleones?
Corleones.
It's a pizza place right next to the courthouse. They got the best pizza and the meatball subs there. I love it.
They got meatball subs?
They got meatball subs. You ever been in? You bite into it. It tastes like a meatloaf.
They're open.
You guys all lunch if you do want to go out together, or
yes.
If not.
I want some of that. Let me get my phone.
No questions.
a car, and it broke my nose like right here. And I don't know if you can still see it, like a small scar.
Yeah.
But I'm lucky I look like I do now, and I think it released a superpower on me. I can actually smell like things like really, really good. I mean, like, he'll be cooking food, and all of a sudden I'll be like, food's going to be ready in about a minute, and then his timer goes off. I was right.
So you do have superpowers.
I guess.
You,
I mean,
you sniffed out the shoplifters.
Yeah,
and
then I'm mad at it.
She got the toucan power up. You know, like Toucan Sam, like follow your nose.
So you're not superhuman or
No, I'm not superhuman. I'm a regular human.
All right.
Maybe with a heart of gold, but I'm a regular human. There was an old gentleman, Mr. Brandt, a nice elderly gentleman. He would always have a neck brace on, and he was always walking in like this, and I knew he always needed a motorized cart. And I'm like, hey, Mr. Brandt, you need a motorized cart? I'd lift that thing up by the front end and drag it right to him and turn it on just for him.
Gail, thank you so much. Do you have any last words? Any message that you've been dying to get out there?
I want people to know at home, I really do appreciate the love and support. I mean, like, it has been an awesome ride, and I hope the ride keeps going, but sometimes I wish the ride would slow down just a little bit. But again, I always appreciate my fans, and I want to say if it wasn't for them, I would never be here to this day.
Attention Walmart, this is Gail Lewis. 10-year associate, Morris, Illinois, 844. Signing out. Good night.
What is your favorite movie?
My favorite movie would actually be Ghostbusters.
Yeah?
And the original Ghostbusters, yeah.
Does that have a connection to the hearse, then?
It kind of does a little bit. I'm not sure if I want to, like, turn it into the Ecto-1, but I'm thinking about it. Signing out. Good night.